A day after becoming the first twice impeached American president to be twice acquitted.
The yeas are 57, the nays are 43.
Donald Trump returned to routine and went golfing.
I spoke to him last night. He was grateful to his lawyers. He appreciated the help that all of us provided. He's ready to move on and rebuild the Republican Party.
A Republican Party that made clear this weekend it's moving forward in Trump's image. In the end, seven GOP senators found Trump guilty.
I voted to convict.
A far more bipartisan vote than his first impeachment trial, in which just one lone Republican voted to convict.
The president is guilty of an appalling abuse of public trust.
Still, the great majority of Trump's party ensured his second trial ended like his first, believing his influence will continue to dominate.
Trump is the most vibrant member of the Republican Party. The Trump movement is alive and well.
Indeed, Trump says his political movement has only just begun.
President Trump just put out the following statement: our historic, patriotic, and beautiful movement to make America great again has only just begun. In the months ahead, I have much to share with you.
Democrats prosecuting Trump say they have no regrets.
Just go back and listen to McConnell's speech. Everybody was convinced of the case we put forward.
The leader of the Senate Republicans blamed the former president for the very thing he found Trump not guilty of just minutes earlier. But hinted the case against Trump may not be over.
President Trump is still liable for everything he did while he was in office. Didn't get away with anything yet.
One prominent member of the anti-Trump wing of the Republican Party agrees the final Donald Trump chapter has not been written.
I think he's still going to face, criminal courts and the court of public opinion. And this is, not over. And we're going to decide over the next couple of years what the fate of Donald Trump and the Republican Party is.
Federal officials have said the massive criminal investigation related to the Capitol attack is not going to be solved in the coming months. Meantime, of the seven Senate Republicans who supported conviction, two of them are not seeking re-election, giving them a bit more political freedom. Only one of them, Senator Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, will be on the ballot in 2022.